for a really special treat. As you can see, there's already props on the stage. What you're about to see is improv of the musical variety. So what you're about to see is a musical that's never been seen before and will never be seen again. And you're only going to give it great reviews, okay? So this group has been touted as the best musical improv group in all of Mad Cowford.
Yes! Okay.
Maybe if we can get a little slow chant going, and I'll give you a little more of this. Get nice and loud, and just hear, more cowbell, more cowbell, more cowbell, more cowbell. Now get loud! More cowbell! More cowbell! Ladies and gentlemen, keep it going for more cowbell!
More cowbell!
Tonight, more cowbell proudly presents an evening of improv and song. These songs have never been heard. We don't know any of the words. We make it up as we go along.
If you'll help us to begin, we just need to answer one question. We'll make a scene out of any old thing. Would you give us
a suggestion?
I'd ever been. My dad had some Jim Beam. That stuff is stronger than it should seem. I lost my shoes. I lost my shoes. I lost my shoes.
You were born to operate a brewery.
I know I've got talent. I can mix flavors. I can make hoppy hoppier, and I can make barley barlier.
Yeah. And you can make rye ryer.
I know. This is my calling, but I'm afraid I might fail. There's so many other microbreweries in town. I need to make mine special. I don't even know what to call it.
I have faith in you. You know, you're the person who drinks more than anybody I know.
I know, that makes me really qualified.
Exactly, and I think the people are gonna see that quality. If they see you at your own brewery, drunk every night, they'll know you're sampling your own product and it must be good.
Absolutely, you know you never eat from a skinny chef. You should never drink from a sober brewerist.
That's exactly it.
Barista, I'm a brewerista.
A brewerista.
Because I'm a lady.
Yes.
Right. And you know, if it weren't for you, my best friend being by my side, it'd be hard to go on.
I'm willing to invest. Yeah.
You're willing to put money behind me?
Absolutely.
Oh, goddamn. Let me give you this one. I just made it. I had you in mind. It's got honey ale in it. Because you're the sweetest thing to ever happen to me. Yeah. And I brew what I brew. You're behind me when I do what I do. Every night when I go to bed. Oh, baby, you're in my head.
Why?
I mean, it's a security guard, and it's the middle of the night, and
No one is robbing bookstores these days. And I just feel like helpless. I feel useless. I feel like this is just a bad TV show.
That badge says so much about you.
Wow.
Get a badge? Got a really big black flashlight.
It's called a mag light.
Oh God!
Jesus. You doing all right, Stephanie? Not really.
Well, actually, you do act like this every time we're on shifts.
Do me a favor, get your walkie-talkie, and just squeeze the button really fast for me.
You mean like an alert button? Like an alert?
Just press a fucking button! Just press it! Just press it a lot! Fast! Press it fast! Faster! That's it, faster! No, just don't stop! Don't stop!
Stephanie, why are you doing this? I don't understand, but every time at 2:30 a.m. this happens.
Albert?
Yeah?
You're a man in uniform. Doesn't matter what uniform, but this one is especially good. Can you arrest me? Do you have handcuffs? Do you have handcuffs? Please tell me you have handcuffs. I'll go buy some right now. Just put the handcuffs.
Okay. Mean Walden Books made me.
Just use some string. I don't care. It's role play. Just tie those. Time up tight.
There's some gimp over here.
I don't know what that means, but just do it anyways. Listen, Albert, I don't think you understand.
I don't understand. Will you just, I'm kind of dense as a guy. I don't really pick up on hints. That's what you're doing. I don't know what it means.
Okay.
I'm focused on my job. Can you just out with what you're trying to say, Stephanie?
Yeah.
Oh,
Bye. Woo! Wait, come back! The mailman just showed up.
It wasn't a book robber!
Take me! Take me!
He took some books down!
Take me! Take me! Do whatever you want! Take me! Take me! Do whatever you want!
This might be the last day you see me in the office.
Really?
Yeah, really.
This is it?
This might be it.
Where are you going? You still don't want to work here anymore?
Oh no, I want to work here. But remember happy hour yesterday?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I put on your glasses.
Well, that was the least of my worries.
Well, they messed my eyes up pretty bad. But there must have been something else I hurt your feelings about.
I think of you as a friend, a confidant.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Oh,
so what
it wasn't
shared
the glasses
with you,
at all.
You know, was not the glasses.
Damn it. Whoa. Yeah.
Remember when I told you how our boss was a piece of shit?
Yeah, and I totally agree.
You did agree. You agreed all over Facebook.
I thought we kind of had a moment, and we were sharing some corn nuggets, and
but you shared the post, tagged me, somehow left your name out of it. I don't know how that happened, but what I'm saying is,
I just, oh man, if it makes you feel any better, my eyes really still hurt.
Okay. Guess what? You have insurance.
Yeah.
You still have a job here. Me, I don't know.
Yeah, I do.
I don't know. Because, you know, for instance, he's an ass. It's a shit. Then I talked about how he's probably cheating on his wife.
And I put you in direct quotes.
You did. You said, Susie thinks that Mr. Armstrong is cheating on his wife. Hashtag Armstrong Industries. That really wasn't necessary.
I thought the hashtag thing was just to say whatever you're talking about. I didn't think it meant anything.
Right.
It's like, hey, I had a good soft drink today, Coca-Cola.
I'm sure the Coca-Cola company appreciates you. Hashtag Coca-Cola.
Also, I went to the doctor and put colonoscopy.
Man, that's crazy. But when you say Armstrong sucks,
oh man,
you kind of put me in a little pickle.
Seriously, I just wanted to see the world through your eyes. So I put your glasses on and it hurt my eyes. I just wanted to be a part of your world. So I direct quoted you and hashtagged your world.
You fucked me.
Just listen to me.
Listen.
There's a reason they call me the funnel, cause I speak everything I hear and see. I tell everybody what happened to me. I don't mind even telling people I had a colonoscopy.
Yeah.
That's your business.
I just thought I could
Call for the colonoscopy.
Something got slipped in.
Double
bunk and daiquiris. Wow. You guys know? Where's the house?
I thought about that.
You mean you don't know? Well, I mean, like,
I thought that was your job.
Designated driver is supposed to remember where the house is.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm officially freaked out.
Did that come out of the trunk?
I'm not gonna ask questions.
I think that noise came out of the trunk.
No, we're not looking in the trunk.
I think we should
look in the trunk. No, if we look in the trunk, then whatever is in there is our responsibility. If you leave the trunk closed, it's like Schrodinger's cat.
There may or may not be something in the trunk.
No, it means there's nothing in the trunk if you can't see it. That's what I read. No.
It might be harmless. It could be harmless.
It might be a parrot.
Whatever it is, it could be dying and it could be our fault.
How are we here? Did we drive here?
Why am I still drinking this?
We were all really drunk.
Alright, I've got the keys. I'm just gonna go to the trunk of the car and I'm just gonna open it up and see what's in there.
Carl, open the trunk,
yes.
Whatever is in there is on you.
Okay.
You see something, you say something.
No, don't say anything.
There's a jam inside. Don't tell us. We don't want to know.
Yeah, we don't want to be brought in. We don't want to be all brought in.
Yeah, yeah, we don't want to see this.
It's probably nothing. It's
whatever it is your responsibility since you're opening the trunk. But
yeah.
It might be benign. It could be dangerous. Okay. So
it could be a face hugger like from Alien.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Really?
I have a tree branch. It was the only weapon I could find.
All right, well, you guys just calm down. It's probably nothing, all right?
All right.
Find
out.
All right. Are we at the drive-in?
Oh, no. This is a girl.
Oh, we picked up a girl.
Damn it.
When did that happen?
I don't know.
Who was driving?
I know.
Whose continental is that?
Am I getting in free to the drive-in?
I know. I am incapable of talking to a woman. So it wasn't me.
Okay.
I'm not capable of talking to a woman either. I always like dry heave and then I vomit.
I fade chicks all the time, but I don't. That's not my. I like brunettes.
Okay, that's bullshit. I'm calling bullshit on that. Hey, let's just ask her who she is. Maybe it's a hazy night. We don't remember. It's probably good. Tell us.
I can't look her in the face.
My name is Veronica. I'm the girl you don't remember.
We don't remember.
You tapped me up at the party and forget then
Okay. I'm used to getting left behind.
Okay, listen, Veronica.
That we're all tagged in a picture.
What?
Shall we take a look? Yes.
Oh, God.
We cut to the picture.
Cut to the picture.